Hi guys, this is Aditya from Lighthaven. Today we are going to go over another basic footwork pattern in Kali. It's called a diamond footwork. This is one of my favorite footwork patterns. Like your ranging footwork, it falls under the basic category, and yet it's a very combative footwork. It also addresses a bunch of different ranges. We can go from long range to medium range to close range. It's also really versatile in the kind of striking patterns you can add along with this footwork. I feel diamond footwork is a really good complement to your ranging footwork because it's actually just an inversion of your ranging footwork. So what I mean by that is your ranging footwork is forward 45 degrees, forward 45 degrees, backward 45 degrees, backward 45 degrees. Right? So it's whether you start with your left leg or right leg, it's forward 45 degrees on your left leg, forward 45 degrees on your right leg, back on your left leg, back on your right leg. Diamond footwork is going to hit the same angles just in a different order. So I'm going to go forward, I'm going forward on my left leg, I'm going forward on my right leg, I've gone back on my right leg, and I've gone back on my left leg. A really important concept to remember in diamond footwork is your center line. The entire footwork pattern is based around moving in and out of center line. What I mean by that is if this is center line, I'm going to step off center line, get my head and body off center line, step back into center line, step off center line, step back into center line. There are two ways of you doing this footwork pattern. One is a single step, where you take one step at a time, and the other is a double step, where you're going double step, double step, double step, double step. What's important to remember though is whether you're doing single step or double step, you need to get your entire body and head off center line and then come back in. Very often you see people stepping off center line, but then this back leg is going to come straight and they're just taking a straight step. There is a time and a place for that, but when you're learning diamond footwork, you want to make sure that once you step off center line, that back leg comes here and then moves back into center line, as opposed to stepping off center line and this back leg just takes a step forward. You want to step off, this leg comes and then it comes back into center line. Whether you want to do it as a double step, do a double step, or whether you want to do a single step and this leg is almost floating, it's in the air. So it's a single step and then I step onto center line. I'm going to break down the single step and double step versions for you once. The single step is I'm taking a single step, either right or left, in front is up to you. Come back to the middle, go backwards, back where I began. Again, now the opposite direction, so if I started on my right side, now I'm going to go left side. Single step, both feet come to the apex. I go backwards, single step, come back home. And then you can just alternate this. Double step is, I'm going to go double step, double step, double step, double step. And now the other direction, double step, double step, double step, double step. For me, if I want to cover more distance, I will use the double step version. If I want to, if I'm a bit closer to my opponent, I can use a single step version. Of course, you can combine the two, where you go single step to double step. But that's really depending on how you want to use the footwork, in what context and what range with what strikes. The way I recommend you doing it is you go one round single step, starting with the right leg and left leg, and then go one round double step, starting with the right leg, coming back with the left leg. And alternate single step and double step. So you go single step, single step, single step, single step, practice with single step, single step, single step, single step, and back home. Now double step, double step, double step, double step. And you just alternate this pattern. So you're getting reps of your single step in and your double step in. We're going to add a simple striking pattern of your angle 1 and angle 2 on top of your ranging footwork, both the single step variation and the double step variation. So it's going to be, as I step out angle 1, center line angle 2, angle 1, angle 1, 2, 1, 2, come back, now double step, 1, 2, 1, 2. To make sure that my striking is timed correctly. So if I take a step without a strike, I'm going to get hit. But if I strike without taking a step, I'm not going to reach my opponent. So I want to be striking as I'm stepping. Same with the next one, as I'm stepping, I'm striking. Same on the way back, because now on the way back, I am assuming that as I vacate this space between me and my opponent is going to fill it. Now I want to determine and dictate the filling of this space. And so as I step back, I am striking to fill that space. Same as I step on the other side, I am striking to fill that space. As usual guys, thank you so much for watching. If you learned something from this video, please do like, subscribe and share. It really does help the channel and the school out a lot. And see you in the next video.